Hey, this is Nikki the Mechanic, aka Nikki Wildlife, and today we're going to show you how to remove a nail from your tire and plug it yourself for less than $30. So now we're going to remove the nail and start the repair process. The items you will need are in this tire plug kit. You can find this at Walmart for about $5 or any auto store for under $20. Tools included, this is the reamer tool, the next tool is the probe tool, and the next will be the plugs, which you'll be plugging the tire up with. The next is the rubber cement that you will need to repair your tire. The first thing we're going to do is use our reamer tube to ream the hole, and that's just to get the hole ready to plug. So we're just going to grind it down like we're screwing something into the tire just to prepare the tire. You just want to do that a couple of times just to kind of roughen it up, so to speak, to get your tire prepared. Next, we're going to loop our probe with one of the plugs. We're going to loop it just like you're going to sew a needle through a thread. That's what you're going to do. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to put our cement glue all over the plug, as you see here. You don't have to be stingy with the cement. Apply it on both sides, all over. Just don't be stingy with the cement. And you can also add some cement into the little hole on the tire. You don't have to, but you can do that as well to make sure everything is coated. Now we're going to start our plug process. We're going to now insert our probe with the plug with the cement into the hole of the tire as such. We're going to push that probe in into that tire. It's going to take a little muscle power, but as you can see here, we're pushing a probe in with the plug and the glue, and it's the size of maybe a small V. Okay, now once we have it wedged into that small V, we're going to go ahead and yank that puppy out. Now we're going to get some cutters. And you can pretty much use anything that's going to cut the plug. So you just want to make sure it's, you know, heavy duty enough to cut it. We're going to go ahead and cut the plug down to a small nub into the tire. Once we're done with that, we're going to go ahead and add air to the tire. Be sure to check my video out on how to add air into your tire. Remember, guys, you need to know your PSI of the tire. You need to know how much air you're going to put into your tire so you can gauge it. You don't want to overinflate your tire because you don't want your tire to pop. You also don't want to drive off balance. Now we're going to do the soapy water test to see if there are any air bubbles after we've added the air to your tire. The reason we're doing this with soapy water, so why soapy water as opposed to regular water? Well, soap creates bubbles so you can see the leak, just like a bubble machine. You don't blow with water, you blow with soapy water. There you have it. So as you can see, we have successfully repaired the nail that was in our tire. The next thing we're going to do is replace the tire and drive the car. Stay tuned. So this is Nikki the Mechanic, aka Nikki Wildlife. Don't forget to like, share, follow, and hit that subscribe button. Until the next video.